It's nice to have LaMichael in there, but to have Kenyon step in there, and you don't miss a step. I didn't see Kenyon miss on any plays that LaMichael would have made great plays on, because Kenyon was pretty much 100% this game. He was good on his blitz pickups, good on checkdowns, good on screens, and then he ran the ball great. Just showed flat-out speed. That's the type of throw that's Darren's specialty. Just that medium-range throw. We call it a two-ball. One ball is on the line, two, kind of a loop on it, and three is a high-arcing ball. He throws that two-ball very well. A little bit of wobble on it, not the best spiral, but he gets it where it needs to be. Right in the guy's gut. It's a good system. Ask any running back, would they rather be in the I formation, going straight downhill and running the ball right at the line of scrimmage, or they'd rather be in the shotgun, sidestepping every play. Everyone's gonna take the I formation because that's just a running back-centric offense. You got a fullback blocking for you. You put a running back in the shotgun, they're not all gonna be successful. It's a tough offense to flourish in as a running back. These are very talented guys doing amazing things. A lot of people are asking, why isn't Darren running the ball? It make us a much more dynamic team. It's because the defense isn't giving us the looks for Darren to run the ball. They can really take the ball out of his hands anytime they want to, but do you wanna do that? Do you wanna put it in LaMichael's hand? Do you wanna put it in DeAnthony's hands? That's your choice. All bets are off, anything can happen. Even though Oregon State's not having a great season this year, Oregon's never gonna underestimate that fact. They're gonna be ready. The Beavs have some very talented receivers that can make some plays on defense. Jordan Poyer comes to mind. Yeah. They have a lot of things to offer, so Oregon will be ready. Oregon State's gonna bring it as well. My favorite would be 2009, Rose Bowl's on the line. We're at home in Autzen in front of all of our fans. We win the game. We go into the locker room, we get the roses presented to us, the Pac-10 championship trophy. It was a magical moment. Haven't shed too many tears in my life, but that was one of the moments where I'll admit I shed a few tears. I think the college football coaches have banded together and decided not to cover Colt Lay earlier this season, because every time he touches the ball, it's a touchdown and no one's around him. You're gonna see nine guys stacked in the box. Every one of them has their eyes in the backfield. The offensive line sells the play action fake down the line, and Colt Lay is completely wide open. Darren's probably laughing to himself, like, okay, here we go. Floats up a nice pass, make him catch it. You can see that on this play, we're gonna have a two vertical concept with a post and a seam. We're gonna isolate this backside safety, who's keying number three on the vertical seam. Number three beats his man, therefore the safety has to help over the top. This opens up the post underneath to Justin Hoffman. You can see that Darren takes a long stride when he throws. When you take a long stride, you lose your core stability, and that causes your arm to do unpredictable things. In this situation, there was an overthrow, and he should complete that pass. Simple speed option, bread and butter. Reads that defensive end. Defensive end takes himself out of the play. Darren's like, okay, I'm gonna keep this ball myself. And you'll still have three UCLA defenders inside of him. Can easily pitch it outside, but feeling a little bit more confident in that knee, and that speed is definitely coming back. Darren looked real quick on this one. There's a pistol formation, a formation that you can run a lot of plays out of, but they decided to run a read option. You can see that Darren is eyeing that defensive end, and he's gonna get the read from him. If the DN takes the running back, he's gonna take the ball himself and go up the field. DN takes the quarterback, he's gonna give to the running back. So he keeps it, takes it to the second level, and now he's at his second read option. That linebacker takes Darren, so he pitches outside of DeAnthony. Receivers have great blocking downfield, and DeAnthony does the rest of the work. Just a great play. But it's not the easiest thing. Brian does a great job of seeing the isolation, and then you're gonna get your tight end and your offensive line out there are gonna make some great cut blocks for you. Brian is great because he has great mechanics. He goes eyes away, and then he comes back to his receiver, throws a nice catchable ball, which is very important. You don't wanna throw a laser cannon shot. Nice and easy, nice pitch, and let him do the rest, and really, DeAnthony does that in this play.
Nate, what does Chip Kelly say to this team after this USC loss to get them ready for Oregon State?
Same thing he says after every game. You got to focus on what's ahead of us. Just take it one game at a time. But like you said, it's bragging rights within the state. Sometimes the Beavers players come down to Eugene and hang out in the Valley River Center Mall. So it's important to have bragging rights when you're hanging out in the mall with your girlfriend, because you got to have that, right?
You got to have the mall turf rights. That's absolutely so. That
you got to love beautiful. The O-line technique. What they're taught is to hook underneath the defensive lineman's armpit and kind of run with them. Yep. Is it holding? I don't know. Matt Brock would probably think it's holding, but do the refs call it? Never do.
You just run
it's
an
genius.
Arm and arm.
I know we talked about him. He played quarterback in high school. A lot of the people don't know that. He was a really good quarterback. He's a smart guy, and he takes that to the tight end position. He's almost like a quarterback in that tight end slot. Yeah. He can block, he can catch, and he knows exactly every route he's supposed to run, where he's supposed to be, and when he's supposed to be there. You're not celebrating a dang thing. You're locked up in your room. You might get to watch a movie if you're lucky. You hear all the fireworks going off outside. You hear people celebrating at the pool, but you're not taking part in any of that stuff. You're focused on the game and getting your rest in.
What is the most important thing that you guys need to do as a leader in order to get the young guys following you and believing and buying into the system?
I think you just gotta lead by example. Could be that young guy who sees you skip a rep in the weight room. That's gonna put a bad example on him. It's gonna be that young guy who sees you miss out on one of your wind sprints. You have to do everything 100%, lead by example, and that's the only way to go.